After learning the foundations of Maxwell's equations and their definitions, in this part of the lecture, let us learn how the Maxwell's equations lead to the understanding of light as magnetic wave propagation. You see in the figure that it is a combination of the wave, is a wave that we see here, electromagnetic wave, is a combination of the magnetic field and the electric field. So that is how it is called as electromagnetic wave. Again, let us look into the summary table. Look at the Maxwell's equation 3 and Maxwell's equation 4. Okay, again, just to recap, you see that here in Faraday's law, the third Maxwell's equation, the curl of E, that is electric field, E is going to give the rate of change in the magnetic field. And in the case of Ampere's law, it is a curl of H, that is a magnetic field, E is going to have an effect on the electric field. Let us see it in detail. Maxwell's equations encompass the major laws of electricity and magnetism. It is interesting to know the similarity between the third Maxwell's equation and fourth Maxwell's equation. The third one, that is in fact Faraday's law, you see that electric field induced due to change in the magnetic field. That is, electric field change induced due to the magnetic field. In the case of Maxwell's hypothesis, that is the fourth Maxwell's equation, magnetic field is created due to the change in the electric field. You see the relation and there is a similarity. Okay, but you understand one thing, at the time when the Maxwell proposed changing electric field create magnetic fields, there were no experimental evidence to prove. Maxwell realized that oscillating charges produce changing electric field. In fact, it is a great intellectual contribution by Maxwell. He predicted that those changing fields would propagate from the source like waves generated in a lake by a jumping fish. That means you could see here that it is a lake in the lake, and you just imagine the fish is jumping. A fish is jumping. What happens when the fish jumps to the lake? There is a wave that is going to be propagated. When a fish jumps again at another point, there is a wave that is going to be generated. So these waves that is going to generate it, that is in the plane of the river or the lake. But then the fish jumps perpendicular to the plane. Okay, so this is very understanding as a very understanding that Maxwell has proposed. The waves predicted consists of oscillating electric and magnetic fields defined to be an electromagnetic wave. Maxwell calculated, you see here, Maxwell in fact calculated the c, that is the speed of light, by using the fundamental constants, which is nothing but mu naught and epsilon naught. That is, mu naught is the magnetic susceptibility and epsilon naught is the electrical permeability, and you know the value, both the values, and by substituting that you could get the velocity of light as 2.99 or approximately 3 into 10 to the power 8 meters per second. Similarly, the characteristic impedance has also been calculated from the very fundamental constant mu naught and epsilon, and which is obtained as 377 ohms. So German physicist Heinrich Hertz generated and detected certain types of electromagnetic wave in the laboratory around 1887. He used AC LCR circuit. He also studied the reflections, refractions, and the interference pattern of electromagnetic waves, verifying their wave characteristics. Hertz calculated further the velocity is frequency times the wavelength. That is what we use nowadays. V is equal to F into lambda, where V is the velocity, F is the frequency, and F is the frequency and lambda is the wavelength. Let us come back to the Maxwell's equation 3 and 4, which is the meaning. Let us see. In the third Maxwell's equation, you see that E in left hand side must be the function of the position and time. Similarly, in the fourth equation, H, that is a magnetic field in left hand side, must be the function of position and time. So that means we have Maxwell's equations give the effect of combination of electric and magnetic fields. This forms the basis for the concept of electromagnetic waves. Let us understand the combination of electric and magnetic field in the figure shown. You see that, let us consider that this is a conductor and there is a current that is flowing. And we know, as per Faraday's law, that curl of E is nothing but rate of change of magnetic flux density. So that means, as the current is moving upward, for example, a magnetic field is going to be generated, or there is a magnetic flux density is going to be there. And now, this magnetic field density is going to create the electric field, because we know from Ampere's Maxwell's equation, del cross H is going to give us the current density in terms of J plus dou D by dou T. So that means we are going to have the electric field here. Now again, the cycle repeats. That means we have the electric field, and then there is a magnetic field that is generated. We have the magnetic field and then electric field that is going to be generated, and this cycle goes on continuous, and wherein we are having the combination of electric and magnetic fields. Let us now derive the wave equations in differential forms in free space in terms of field, especially in terms of electric field. Consider Maxwell's equation 3 and 4. We have third, that is del cross E is equal to minus dou V by dou T, and del cross H is equal to J plus dou D by dou T. And also we know the fundamental equations B is equal to mu H and D is equal to epsilon E. Let us substitute that B and D in the equations 1 and 2. Let us rewrite in terms of equation 4 and 5. So that means on the right hand side it will be minus mu into dou H by dou T, and del cross H is equal to J plus epsilon into dou E by dou T. Consider equation 4, that is del cross E is equal to minus mu into dou H by dou T, wherein we will have to eliminate the magnetic field, taking curl on both sides of equation 4. So that means there already we have a curl of E, which we need to write it as curl of E. Del cross E is equal to minus mu into dou T, dou by dou T, sorry, minus mu dou by dou T of del cross H, which is the equation 6. Let it be equation 6. Further, vector field E, the curl of curl is defined by del of del dot E minus del square E. Let it be equation 7, where del is the usual del operator and del square is a vector Laplacian. Let us recall again one more Maxwell's equation, that is 1, wherein you have that divergence of D is nothing but the charge density, that is rho V. So in that equation, let us replace D with epsilon E, and we can rewrite it as del dot E is equal to rho V by epsilon. That let it be equation 8. Now substituting equation 8 in equation 7, what we have on the right hand side is del into rho V by epsilon minus del square E. Let it be equation 9. In this slide, again I am keeping equation 5, 6 and 9, which is required for me now. Okay, so from equation 6 and 9, you see that left hand sides are equal, so that means I can equate the right hand side. So del into rho V by epsilon minus del square E is equal to minus mu into dou by dou T of del cross H. Let me repeat. Del rho V by epsilon minus del square E is equal to minus mu into dou by dou T of del cross H. Let it be equation 10. So using equation 5 in the right hand side of equation 10. So what I can write is dou into rho V by epsilon minus del square E, which is the same as the above equation, is equal to minus mu into dou by dou T of J plus epsilon into dou E by dou T. So just by rearranging, I can write the equation, this equation, you see. So in that equation, let it be equation 11. So equation 11 is nothing but the wave equation for the electric field in the time domain. In free space, observe that in the free space, charge density is equal to 0 and J is also equal to 0. Then equation 11 will become, or it will just reduce in the right hand side to 0. So that means del square E minus mu naught epsilon naught into dou square E by dou T square is equal to 0. That equation let it be 12. So we have the wave equation in terms of electric field, that is this one. And let me just show you the wave equation for the magnetic field, which in fact is not there in the syllabus, but you could compare the equation. So that is in the time domain, it is del square H minus mu epsilon into dou square H by dou T square is equal to mu sigma into dou H by dou T. In free space, it will reduce to, that is just left hand side is equal and right hand side is going to be 0, similar to the previous one. Before going further, let us see what is a wave front. Now you have a wave here, this is a wave that we have, and you have, I have marked this red lines here. This each red line is nothing but represents a particular frequency with a particular angle. And that means if you just imagine at a distance that these lines in another view, let us say that it is in a oblique view that I am considering, you have that line as just as a plate, just as a plate, as you could see here. Okay, and these plates are nothing but, or can be imagined as, the fronts or the wave fronts. To define, you can define it in a different ways. Maybe I can define it as one way. A plane wave is a constant frequency wave whose wave fronts are infinite parallel planes of constant peak to peak amplitude normal to the phase velocity vector. Phase velocity vector represents this, that is a movement of the wave. Movement of the wave is nothing but the phase velocity vector. Okay. Or other definition could be, it is a wave whose surfaces of constant phase are infinite parallel planes normal to the direction of propagation. However, in reality, it is not possible to have true plane wave. Electromagnetic signal generated from a localized source, say for an antenna, in a region very far from it, can be treated as a plane wave. Let us get the relation between mu naught, epsilon naught, and c, that is the speed of light in vacuum. And we know the electromagnetic wave, that is the magnetic wave and electric wave, which are perpendicular to, mutually perpendicular to each other and propagate in the same directions. So that is what we know about electromagnetic radiation. So we need to have the definition of general equation for a traveling wave. Let us consider that for Ey and Bz. For Ey, the general equation for a traveling wave is Ey vector is equal to minus, Ey vector is equal to A cos 2 pi by lambda into x minus at of Ey cap. That let it be equation 1. Similarly, Bz vector is equal to 1 over c into A cos 2 pi lambda into x minus ct of Az cap. Let it be equation 2, where c is the velocity of propagation of electromagnetic wave in free space or vacuum, and as I explained, Ey and Bz are mutually perpendicular and they are in phase. Let us get the ratio of equation 1 and 2, that is Ey by Bz, and we are going to get that as C. That let it be equation 3. Further, let us consider the wave equation for an oscillating quantity F vector. That is nothing but del square f minus 1 over v square into dou square f by dou t square is equal to 4, where v is the velocity of the wave. From the previous derivation, we know that wave equation for a plane wave in free space is nothing but del square e minus mu naught epsilon naught into dou square E by dou t square is equal to 0. Let it be equation 5. Now, in equation 4 and 5, you can compare 1 over V square with mu naught and epsilon naught, because the equations are almost similar. So, when we compare that, you are going to get V is equal to 1 over root mu naught epsilon naught. So if you consider the free space, this velocity is nothing but the velocity of light, that can be written as just c. So what we have finally is c is equal to 1 over root mu naught into epsilon naught. Observe this equation very carefully. It is having mu naught and epsilon naught, which are magnetic and electric parameter. You just observe that when Maxwell has had found a fundamental relation between two seemingly unrelated phenomena, by then electromagnetic field and light. Imagine the excitement that Maxwell must have felt when he discovered equation 6.